Hi, Kimmy. What you up to? What you doing?
Nothing much. I'm just playing and trying to take my mind off this algebra exam I have next week.
How is randomly playing going to help you?
At least it's going to take my mind off.
Why don't I actually try teaching you algebra, and this may probably even help you get a better grade in school. Let's take these pencils, and this is something that I used to do in school when, well, I actually liked stacking these pencils up till they actually tipped off and fell. Right now, let me just stack these pencils as we go along. And when I'm taking these two pencils and putting them there, I call them as levels. So let me ask you a question. How many levels do we have here?
Three.
And how many pencils have I used in total?
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Six, right? So let me build two more levels. This is level five. So how many pencils do I have in total?
So six plus one, two, three, four, that is 10.
Yes, now if I make this 30 levels, let me complicate it further. If I make this 60, how many pencils have I used? You don't need to be this perplexed. We can actually use algebra to actually solve this particular problem. Now, and that's exactly what we do in mathematics as well. We try finding out patterns. And let's try finding patterns out here. Let me just remove all of this out and let's deconstruct this. Initial level had got two pencils. The next level has got two more pencils, which effectively means if I've built two levels, I've used four pencils. Now, if I build the third level, it's got six pencils. Now, do you observe a pattern? Do you see that two pencils is always a constant for every level, which effectively means every level we are adding two pencils and two becoming a constant. Therefore, as and when I keep increasing levels, all that I will have to do is to keep adding two. And in algebra, all that we basically do is to have this written as 2 into n, where n is the number of levels that you will basically be having. Therefore, you will have 2n, and if it is 30 levels, you will have 2 into 30, that is going to be 60 pencils. If you have 100 levels, you will have 2 into 100, which is going to be 200 pencils. And algebra actually made it very, very easy for you to solve all of this. This is what mathematics and algebra does. It takes complex concepts and puts them into simple patterns. And in this case, the pattern was 2n. Now, let me try showing you another pattern. Now, let's take a single triangle. And let me flip this and make it into another bigger triangle. Now, there are three triangles in the second row. Let me do the same action again. Let's flip this once more. And I see five triangles in the third row. So the first row has got one triangle, the second row has got three triangles, the third row has got five triangles. Let me continue and show you a pattern here. Now, if I start tallying the total number of triangles that are there, first row has got one triangle, the first and the second row put together has got four triangles, the first, second, and the third row put together has got nine triangles. Do you see a pattern? One, four, nine. And that happens to be square numbers. And such a complex diagram in terms of algebra and in terms of patterns has been simplified into a pattern which is n squared, where n is the number of rows that are there in the triangle. So when I say n is equivalent to 1, I get one triangle. When n is equivalent to 2, I get four triangles. When n is equivalent to 3, I get nine triangles. And I can continue. N is equivalent to 4 gives me 16. N is equivalent to 5 gives me 25. N is equivalent to 6 gives me 36. And I can go on and on and on. And even if I have to actually find if n is equivalent to 100, that will just give me 10,000 triangles. Have you seen triangles and patterns this way? Do you want to learn algebra in this format? Do you want to learn algebra in this format?